unfortunate situation, no?
I've had worse.
Indeed, indeed. This is a very deep pit, and in this such a historic venue, I feel sure there may be valuable artifacts lurking in its depths.
I can't tempt you to jump down and look.
Well, this is my point. I feel you may be better qualified to examine its secret, unless you, perish the thought, expired in the fall. Perhaps if you lighten your load a little, it may lessen the impact. The stone you carry?
Wondered when you'd get to that. Pull me up, and the stone's yours.
And we all leave happily ever after? I think not. give me your word that once you leave the pit, you will not lay a finger on me.
You have my word.
The stone? Now, Miss Croft, you gave me your word. Come now, Lara. Lara, you promised!
Boo!
Could you find it in your heart to help me up? I appear to be sleeping!
Pierre, you know nothing would please me more, but we have an agreement.
Agreement?
Not to lay a finger on you, remember, silly? Anyway, busy girl, got to go.
But I...
Don't let me hold you up.
And so ended the first of many. I'm sure Miss Croft would be the first to apologize for her not entirely courteous behavior regarding some of the more delicate religious artifacts, Father Patrick.
No need, my friend. All in a good cause. At least we knew they were in secure hands. And fortunately, the church was above sending a bulletproof envoy to retrieve them.
Ah, but she recognized her place in the great scheme. Some things, as history has illustrated, best left to their slumber. I speak in riddles. I talk of the stricken wolf ship.
Ah, the U-boat episode. Miss Croft would never enlighten me as to the details. For my own protection, she would often stress.
Indeed, Winston. And for this, you should be grateful. Deep in the bowels of their vessels lay one of the most powerful artifacts in all Christendom. An artifact which, when wielded at the vanguard of an army, would make that army invincible.
The Spear of Destiny.
But the boat never reached the Fatherland with its precious cargo. It disappeared from radar 3 weeks into the journey. This was the resting place of the 52 seamen, and also something much more sinister. The Zapadnaya Litsa port, once the pride of the Russian fleet. Ex-KGB, the majority of them. Trained killers.
Dealt with mafioso before. Unpleasant memories. Prefer to avoid them whenever possible.
Yes, I would prefer this also.
Hardly a major search party, is it? There's something you're not telling me.
Ah, yes.
I'm a big girl now. Hit me with the bad news.
It is bad news. The Admiral's allegiance has been bought, and under his command, a nuclear submarine. It's housed in one of the dockyards.
Well done. Nuclear submarine. Sounds nice. Perfect holiday.
Lara, wait. Take this tracking device.
What's this? You're not worried about me.
Yes, somebody has to.
Touching. But don't wait up.
Thank you. such extortionate prices for incompetence.
You forget, Mikhailov. I am still an admiral of the Russian Navy, and as such, demand respect.
While you accept my bribes for use of the submarine, you are under my employ and will follow my instructions without complaint.
If I deal with the like of you to keep my men in bread, it does not make me one of you.
Ha ha! Relax, my friend. We are two sides of the same coin.
Mafioso filth. Khrushchev, hurry on with that box. Our new commander demands efficiency. Enough, enough! Board and seal hatches.
As you have promoted me to commander, is it not fitting to board before the admiral?
Thank you.
Economy class.
An unwelcome addition to our little assignment. Leonid, if you would escort this lady to the brig.
Your little assignment? You have no idea what your mafia-financed assignment is, do you, Admiral?
Young lady, who you are and what you know is of very little concern to me. If I was captain of my ship, I might listen to you. But unfortunately, the situation I find myself in doesn't allow me that privilege. So if you would be quiet and hurry along like a good little girl. Circumstances, open this door. Do you understand?
Thank you.
Intellect to grasp.
Perhaps too much for my trusted comrade, but perhaps not for the spy we have located on board.
A spy? I trust you disposed of him.
Not him, her. Yes, we are forced to run with the wolves, but we shall not kill indiscriminately like they.
Fool! I shall dispose of her when I return. Move the sub to position. Quickly, comrade.
Take her 5 degrees astern, quarter power, and bring her to a full stop. Attention, all dive crews. Report to your stations immediately.
Ah! No.
Thank you. Thank you.
unannounced visitor. I fear you have an item in your possession that I require.
To be used in your continuing quest for world peace, I presume.
World peace, not entirely my purpose in pursuing this artifact.
This artifact contains untold power. Power of which the likes of you will never harness. If you wish it, you may have it. But you will regret it.
The world may regret it. Hand it to me and I may spare you.
On your head be it.
Take her to the torpedo room and eject her into the ocean.
Sergei, listen to me. You don't know what you're dealing with.
my ship with his greed. And now we are all doomed.
We have a chance. The escape pod, come on. I'll help you.
I do this only to help my men. He babbles of the biblical spear, and I feed his madness for money to feed our families. And now, to these corpses left for the fishes.
Yarrowfen, I can help you, but you must help me. The ship is about to impact into the ocean bed, and then our time is up. We must hurry.
The escape pods have no internal air supply. You will find oxygen tanks in my stateroom. I hear my ship dying. The internal seams are splintering.
Thank you.
yet. No time. The hull is breached, and we will drown soon. With the oxygen, you escape now.
Not without you.
I am Admiral Yarovev of the Russian Imperial Navy. I have served my great country for many years, but the country I know withers. The bear lies down to sleep for its final time. And I wish also this fate on the ship I have grown to love.
No deal.
Yes, deal. For the outer airlock can only be opened from inside the ship. This is my gift to you, child. I release you to a future beyond this dying vessel.
And my gift to you?
Tell my story. Tell how the proud men of the Russian Navy fought against the enemy from inside and sacrificed their lives for that their country may once again stand proud.
You have my word.
I salute you. Quickly, into the airlock, and I will release you.
Goodbye, Admiral.
Saw enough of the power of this artifact to recognize its rightful place was where man could never again misuse it.
And not enough for it to destroy her. Some powers are beyond the wit of man.
Oh dear, gentlemen. I do apologize. It seems someone up above has a sense of humor. If you will excuse me a moment, I shall fetch candles.
It is a knight spurred by hell.
And as the horsemen drove ever onwards across the world, the heavens boiled in their wake. Ah, benefits of a religious education. This night reminds me of the time out at Canusi.
Winston's home?
Indeed, yes. The staff had taken leave due to flooding. Lara, back when she was a slip of a girl, was staying with Winston and his wife. It was her that contacted me, as a matter of fact. Some trouble out on one of the islands. Weird lights, manifestations, that sort of thing. Thought I might be able to help. It was on a hellish night like this when I arrived. Evening, Winston. And how would I be able to help? So, people have seen these apparitions out on the island.
There is talk of little else in the village, Bram. I'm doing all I can to keep this gossip from Lara.
You would be a wise man. It would be unwise for her curiosity to draw her to that place.
And you have some idea of what it could be?
To be frank with you, no. But as the devil finds work for idle hands, I've spoken with Father Finnegan and have a boat chartered for the crossing late on this very evening.
Good Lord, Bram. You have not chosen the evening for it.
I have my faith to protect me, Winston.
Be careful. I fear on that island it's what you cannot see that will hurt you, Bram.
Time to get to the bottom of this, old friend.
Thank you. This visage, it is but a vessel for my troubled spirit. Come closer, for you are safe, while I am hung like so much butcher's meat.
Who are you?
Who? For it is more like what, condemned to wander between the kingdoms of man and that of the elementals. But I must be swift in my request, for they watch and wait to once more draw me back into the darkness.
Request?
My heart, girl. They have hidden my petrified heart in the roots of this, the world tree, down under the watchful gaze of the dragon Nidhogg. Find this, my child, and return it to its rightful resting place. And you shall be rewarded.
And why on earth should I trust you?
Not on Earth, girl. In between. My soul is gone, and how it fares, nobody knows, and nobody cares.
Thank you.
No.
Mm-hmm.
Gift for you. You cantankerous old worm.
you, priest. If you live till doomsday, you shall burn a week longer than the world, I swear!
Iron, never found a demon yet that doesn't burn at its touch.
What was in the hole?
In the... Never mind that. What on earth are you doing here? No, don't bother. We'll get onto that later. Right now, we need to get you out to somewhere safe until the morning. That's assuming you'll stay in one place, young lady.
Nothing with demons, right?
Well, I can't promise anything in this godforsaken place. I light the way and go on ahead to clear out any unwelcome guests. Now, once you're out, head to the chapel over the bridge. I'll meet you there. I'm forgetting me manners. Don't speak to strange things. And if there's anything around, and trusting your skills in this area, there shouldn't be. Iron girl, use iron to repel them. See you up top. Keep your wits about you.
Thank you.
No.
It's me. I've enough on my plate without you making me jump out of my skin and all.
Your hair.
What about me hair?
It's white.
That'd be right. I was detained by some unpleasant fellas from down below. Gave me quite a fright. That's why I wasn't at the chapel. But I can see you've kept yourself busy. Anyways, let's get you out of here and back to safety. Right, young lady. I'm going to have a quick look around now for a safe place to put you. Now, you stay put, or you'll be banging into something that'll make your hair turn white. And we wouldn't be wanting that now, would we?
Father, I found a book in the labyrinth.
You've been sightseeing in there as well. Good Lord almighty, girl. I've been needing to chain you to something.
It has protective symbols. Maybe you could use them.
Bless you for the thought, but I've enough protection from him above. And for that diagram to be any good, you'd have to draw it out and be sitting in the middle of it. And you know something? I've left all my colouring pens at home tonight. Now, you'd be doing me a big favour if you were to stay put before you bang into something bigger than you.
Stay put. Right.